The stretch, the look over, Sierra's short lead, and the delivery is swung on, and a deep drive to right, way down the line, it might go. Goodbye, home run, game tie. Gino Petrolli on the first pitch from Roger Clemens has tied the game. A right field home run. Oh, my. Here's the stretch. Schiraldi's 2-1 to Sierra, and a swing and a long drive to deep right center. Way back at the wall, it is going. Goodbye. Hello, wind column. Ruben Sierra has homered off Calvin Schiraldi in the bottom of the ninth. And the Rangers have beaten the Boston Red Sox 4-2. The 1986 Texas Rangers. Spring training, Pompano Beach. A youthful manager prepares his bright young players to move into season-long pennant contention.
Before the ball's hit, for that ball over there, I'm diving. You back me up, okay?
I was really excited getting to spring training from the personal standpoint because it was my first spring training as a major league manager, and also as a collective organizational standpoint, because we had so many decisions to make and we had so much young talent to look at, evaluate, and decide on. And we came out working, we never stopped working.
Oh, I told the guys that I like our team to be the most improved team in baseball this year.
Bobby Valentine's talented rookies caught on quickly. Key acquisitions solidified his squad, and a largely untested pitching staff began to turn question marks into winning answers. Manager Valentine led his club into opening day with unreserved confidence that the Rangers would fulfill his goal of becoming baseball's most improved team. A record opening crowd of 41,000 fans bought the hottest ticket in town. With Toronto as the foe, the Rangers provided fireworks from the start. A big blast by Larry Parrish provided the difference.
And the pitch. Parrish hits one deep. Right center field. Mosby back. He's at the wall. That ball is history.
Texas bats powered rookie Jose Guzman to victory.
I know that it was a big challenge for Jose Guzman. We were opening up without Charlie Huff. We had a great crowd. It was SRO, as I recall. It was an exciting win.
A 6-3 Rangers triumph as Greg Harris nailed down the win. With Charlie Huff hurt, three rookie starters kept Texas near first place. Edwin Correa picked up his first victory April 14th. The win came 15 days before his 20th birthday.
Ed Correa is a 19, 20-year-old pitching like he's been in the big leagues 5 or 6 years. Great talent base, has three quality pitches, and will be a force in the American League for a number of years.
On May 2nd, Correa blanked the Yankees on three hits. He is the youngest Ranger ever to pitch a shutout.
I was excited because I had men on third and two outs, and I said, well, here's the ball game. You know, I just have to go and to go get him. And when I struck out that guy, I just felt like a new man. You know, first hit out in the big leagues against New York, you know, it's something. So that was very exciting for me.
Correa and Bobby Witt would become baseball's first rookie teammates ever to each strike out at least 150 hitters.
Bobby Witt, sky's the limit with this man. He's Nolan Ryan, Clements type fastball, great makeup, work ethic is outstanding. He's just now figuring out what the big leagues is all about. Next year, he'll be even better.
Witt's first professional win came April 22nd. Using a blazing fastball and a biting slider, the righty went on to fan 9 or more men 8 times, including a club record 14K performance against Detroit. Texas showed faith in its youngsters, and it paid off.
I think it's more or less a commitment Bobby made. He kind of stuck with the young people the whole way through, you know, myself, Eddie, Guzzi. You know, we were struggling there for a while, you know, and I'm sure any other manager might have just sent us down to AAA for a while, get a little time in down there.
Spending time in the big leagues meant learning from the Rangers' innovative coaching staff.
I really am proud of the job that my coaches did this year. In particular, Tommy House working with the pitchers, a traditionalist who has some different ways of expressing traditional ideas.
A key break with tradition was the use of footballs to improve baseball throwing skills.
Well, I'd like to say the football was my idea, but it's not. I got it from the trainer with the San Diego Padres in the early 70s. The football is a real good device to help maintain strength and keep mechanics sound. But mostly it's fun.
There was more fun for Ranger players and fans in May. Charlie Huff returned from a broken finger to again baffle American League hitters with his knuckleball. Their top starter back in the saddle, the Rangers geared up for a pennant race. Huff made a winning debut May 6th against Detroit, leaving the Tigers helpless at the plate. The 38-year-old right-hander immediately hit stride as he started toward the winningest season of his 12-year career. In his second outing at Cleveland, Huff left no doubt that he still had his stuff. All year, Huff cleaned up on the mound with great strength. He hurled 230 innings, including a 13-inning performance that set a club record. The Rangers' strong pitching staff relied on dependable Don Slott, one of the top young names in catching. Right off the bat in 1986, Slott's hitting prowess propelled Texas in a winning direction. Early in the season, Slott teamed with first baseman Pete O'Brien to give Texas the league's top two hitters. The prize pupils made instructor Art Howe proud.
He's using the whole field this year, driving the ball in all directions. Don Slott just started off great. He's been hot ever since spring training, hitting the ball in all directions. I think that's the main key to our hitters. Everybody uses the whole field generally, and that's the only way you hit for an average.
The chilling challenge of bottling up the Rangers' torrid attack often proved to be too much for opposing pitchers to handle.
Swung on, hit deep to right field. Barfield doesn't even move. A towering home run for O'Brien. The fourth Ranger homer of the night. It is 10-1 Texas.
O'Brien's blistering bat started him toward career highs in batting average, home runs, and game-winning hits.
O'Brien is just an outstanding individual and a wonderful human being, besides being as good a player, I think, as anybody would want on a team playing first base, hitting in the middle of the lineup.
He's a sweet swinger. It's going to hit you 20, 25 home runs and drive you in anywhere from 85 to 100 runs this season.
Texas onslaughts routed opponents repeatedly as the Rangers moved into first place on May 11th. The next day, Texas smashed its way into the record book. The Rangers massacred the Indians on the strength of a Larry Parrish homer and a barrage of hits. When the dust settled, Texas had itself team records for runs and hits. In the week after the resounding victory, the Rangers faced a major obstacle. Don Slott and Larry Parrish both went down with injuries. But Texas picked up the slack. Versatile Tom Pachorek was a fine fill-in all year, batting .286 and tying a team record with a five-hit game. Reserve catcher Daryl Porter provided power. Porter's 12 home runs gave him an outstanding mark of a homer for every 13 at-bats. With a reloaded lineup behind him, Mike Mason pitched a shutout May 20th as Texas moved into position for recapturing first place. Mason had his fourth straight win, and his strong showing readied the Rangers for a rousing rally against Boston.
Pitch is swung on and a ground ball deep second base hit. O'Brien scores. Road around third. He scores. The Rangers win. Hello, first place. Bobby Jones is being surrounded and mobbed at first base. He has singled to right on a 3-2 pitch with two out in the bottom of the ninth inning, and the Rangers are in first place.
The Rangers rule the West for a team record 32 straight days. Rookie Pete Incaviglia spearheaded the attack and the arrival of rookie Ruben Sierra gave Valentine's first place troops even more punch.
And a long drive to left. Way back, Ronnie Smith. He's looking up, and that ball is history.
Otobe McDowell's all-out style ignited the team. Celebration became commonplace for the Rock'em Sock'em Rangers.
Incavilla has single, and the Rangers have the magic. Oh, seven straight.
Otobe McDowell is in a three-run home run in the top of the 16th.
Gary Ward also provided excitement at bat as Texas stayed on top until late June. Ward hit a career-high 316.
Here's the throw by Canseco to the plate. He scores an inside-the-park home run.
From the start, Bobby Valentine saw his team as first-place material. Valentine's teaching ability and winning attitude inspired the young Rangers to become baseball's most improved team.
Well, Bobby's our focal point of our enthusiasm, of our determination.
It's good to have him over here. He's enthusiastic, and he's been a big plus for the ball club.
I think the biggest thing that Bobby Valentine brings to this club is his love for the game. And everything he brings out in other people is because of Bobby Valentine's love for baseball.
Bobby Valentine's love for baseball spread like wildfire. His bubble-blowing, head-scratching knowledge and zest for the game evolved into the greatest love of all. Valentine brought his first-place Rangers to Anaheim for a series against the second-place Angels. On June 16th, Charlie Huff flirted with pitching history, holding California hitless into the ninth inning. Huff's 36-year-old manager reveled in the masterful display that he was witnessing. When Huff headed for the hill in the ninth, he had Angel fans on his side. With two outs to go and a runner at third base on an error, Huff faced Wally Joyner.
2-2 pitch to Joyner, and a swing and a line drive up the middle, base hit, the game tied, and the no-hitter is gone.
I felt that game for Charlie because I wanted Charlie in the worst way, in the greatest way, to get that no-hitter.
Though Huff didn't get his no-hitter, and the Rangers fell from first, Huff earned his first All-Star berth. As the season's second half began and the pennant race heated up, Texas continually looked for hot corner heroics from Steve Buechele. The second-year Ranger established himself as one of the league's finest young infielders.
My philosophy on defense is catch the ball and throw the runner out and try to be relaxed and have a good time out there.
Buechele's glove nailed down outs, and he put runs on the board with a quick bat.
Buechele swings on a high, deep drive. Still in the air. Goodbye, Rangers lead.
The 25-year-old Buechele blasted 18 home runs. His stellar all-around play complemented Scott Fletcher's best year ever at shortstop. Nicknamed the Scooter, Fletcher came to the Rangers in a trade and never stopped proving that he is long on desire and talent.
He's as good a fielder as there is in baseball. He was as clutch a hitter as we had. If he wasn't the glue that kept us together, then really no one was.
Fletcher burned up the league in July, hitting in 19 straight games and earning Player of the Month honors. He went on to lead the team with 34 doubles and batted an even 300. He also had his first five-hit game. Perhaps Fletcher's biggest hit came July 29th.
And the pitch is swung on and a drive hit pretty deep to left, way back, and it's off the wall. McDowell around third being waved home. The Rangers are going to win.
McDowell has scored. Fletcher has just hit one off the wall in left field. And the Rangers have won it in the bottom half of the 12th inning with two out.
Sparked by Fletcher, Texas made news on a heart-stopping stretch of one-run games and come-from-behind wins to stay in hot pursuit of the Angels. Fittingly, Don Slott, on his own comeback trail, came through July 30th with a dramatic home run. Texas never quit, getting 11 comeback wins in the next 20 days. The streak began with a three-game series against the surging Orioles.
Keep pulling up games all throughout the year that have been exciting, but I'll tell you, I think our series in Baltimore just sticks out in my mind.
They just seemed to hit the ball all over the place, and they kept getting big leads, but we just kept coming back and beating them.
I think one game we came from behind like five or six runs.
We ended up taking two or three in Baltimore and sending them tumbling a little bit and kind of catapulting us the other way.
At the letters, the 2-2 pitch is swung on and a deep drive to left. Way back, goes Sheets, it is going, it is goodbye, a grand slam home run for Toby Herrera. Now looks at first, throws home. Parrish hits one down the line, fair. Incavilla scores. Ward, the lead run, goes to third. Problems in the corner by Shelby. They're going to try to score Ward. The throw to the plate is late. Run scores. The Rangers lead. One ball and two strikes. And the pitch to Stefaro grounded. Right side, Herrera diving to his left. Has it. Throws to first. He's out. Hello, wind column. Herrera from his stomach throws him out. And the Rangers win. A tremendous diving stop by Toby Herrera, and the Rangers have done it again.
We weren't relying on one, two, or three people to do it for us. And when you have that kind of team effort, it's easy for another guy to want to play the hero's role.
Playing the hero August 9th was number 9, Pete O'Brien.
The swing and a long drive.
We haven't quit after six innings or five innings. When we've been down, we've kept coming back and showed this year, and we've had a lot of fun with the come-from-behind victories, and it's just the confidence we had in ourselves this year.
And the pitch to Sierra. Swung out line to right base hit. Here comes Slott. Hello, wind column. Ruben Sierra has singled to right, and the Rangers win.
When you have the belief in yourself, but also the belief in your teammates, the teammates know that you believe in yourself and you know that your teammates are pulling for you and believe in you, then those things can happen, and they can happen on a regular basis. I think we did it 45 times or so at home this year, came back when we were behind. So that's a sign of belief and confidence.
You can look in the dugout and see many times that Bobby believes that we're going to win no matter how many runs we're down or what inning it is. So the attitude is just that no matter what happens, we are going out expecting that we are going to win.
But few expected Lightning to strike twice on August 25th in a nationally televised matchup of Boston Red Sox ace Roger Clemens and Ranger rookie fireballer Bobby Witt.
Sure, I remember that because that was a real exciting game here before our hometown fans, and real exciting for a lot of our young players. That emotion and the confidence that I showed in him to pitch in Monday night game of the week against Roger Clemens, who's going for his 20th win, is something I'll always remember. And from that time on, Bobby Witt did not lose a game.
Witt finished the season with 7 straight wins. Clemens lost his shutout in the 8th inning when pinch hitter Gino Petrolli stunned everyone with a 2-run home run to tie the game and knock out Clemens. Petrolli's home run was a great surprise, but he wasn't the Lone Ranger hero of the night. With the score still tied in the bottom of the ninth, Ruben Sierra connected off reliever Calvin Schiraldi for a 2-run homer to give Texas another come-from-behind victory. The Rangers never say die attitude showed California it was in for a fight to the finish.
We kind of thought we'd move away from the pack, and Texas wouldn't let us. And they just hung tough all year, and we were very impressed with the way they hung in for as long as they did.
The Rangers were able to hang in all season because of a strong bullpen. When Texas placed the call for relief, things were all right with a talented bullpen of 30-year-old rookie Dale Mahorsa, proven stopper Greg Harris, long man Jeff Russell, and lefty Mitch Williams. A full house of able arms featured Russell in the role of keeping the Rangers close in the middle innings. Russell responded to the opportunity, posting a 5-2 record. Texas fortunes were in good hands with a 21-year-old Williams, who fanned 90 men in 98 innings. Williams made quite an impression, posting 8 saves and 8 wins in a Major League rookie record 80 appearances. The Williams and Mahorsik rookie show could become a long-running hit.
Mitch Williams, I think talent-wise, is the best left-handed reliever in the big leagues. Dale is, we call him the horse, and that's just what he is. You give him the ball, he goes out and throws ground balls. He kept getting better and better and better with no adverse effects, so we just kept giving him the ball.
Mahorsik tied a Major League record by appearing in 13 straight games. The control specialist finished with 7 saves and a team-best 2.5 earned run average. Greg Harris struck late and often, notching 20 saves and 10 victories.
Greg Harris is kind of our ace in the hole. He's going to give you 20 saves and 10 wins as long as he wants to walk out there.
That's where I like to be, right in the middle of all the action, you know, pressure situations. Seems to bring the best out of me.
Harris finished the season with 7 straight wins. The Rangers' dependable bullpen and their exciting winning brand of baseball brought a record number of fans to Arlington Stadium. Everyone had fun all summer long.
We had a good time on the field playing, but the fans have had a great time watching us and coming out to the ballpark, and it's just created a tremendous atmosphere out here.
Texas fans saw fireworks throughout the pennant race from an explosive Ranger offense. Texas bats blasted a club record 184 home runs, including 7 in one game. For the first time in history, 8 Rangers had 10 or more homers, including 3 players with at least 20.
Goodbye! Another home run for Pete O'Brien.
My goodness, it's one of the longest ever at Arlington Stadium for Pete and Cavalier.
Going and goodbye, home run Larry Parrish.
Sierra hits one deep, way back to right. It is going, going, goodbye, the game's tied.
The middle of the lineup the entire season was Pete O'Brien, Pete Incaviglia, Larry Parrish, and then we got an influx of Ruben Sierra, and their power statistics were as good as any power statistics in the league for the middle of the lineup. Larry Parrish, I think, has excited me as much as anybody on this team this year with the year that he had.
And what a year it was. Parrish led Texas with 94 runs batted in. LP missed a month with injuries, but still hit 28 homers and set a club record in slugging percentage. Texas possessed a power-packed outfield. Center fielder Otobe McDowell got things going, batting leadoff. Combining power and speed, he set a club record for runs scored and led the club in stolen bases. Little Mac swatted 18 homers. 20-year-old Ruben Sierra said hello June 1st. In just half a season, Sierra clubbed 16 round trippers and became baseball's youngest player to homer from both sides of the plate in the same game. Sierra set a team record with 10 triples. The strongest rookie to make his mark was Pete Incaviglia. The burly right fielder jumped from college to the majors, leading Texas in home runs and silencing his critics.
Most people in baseball said there was no way he would ever play in the major leagues. then about 100% more of them said there's no way he could play this year in the major leagues. And Pete not only played, but he starred.
It was his rookie season without any minor league baseball, and I expect him to come back next year and hit anywhere between 35 and 40 home runs. I really do.
Ball one and strike two. Sutton throwing home, and a swing and a long drive to right. Way back. That is up. It is going. It is goodbye. Number 30 to right field. He has tied the single season home run record as a Ranger. One of the truly fine moments for the Rangers in 86.
In a year filled with thrills, Texas finished a strong second. Charlie Huff capped off the season with his 17th win, a personal best. The Rangers took 3 of 4 from division-winning California to finish with an 87-75 record, representing baseball's biggest improvement. The Rangers' best season in 8 years included a home mark surpassed by no team in the American League. With the Rangers' accomplishments this year, there's no question that the future is oh so bright.
You know, we're looking to coming back and winning this thing next year.
I'm doing all right, getting good grades. The future's so bright.